to day 22 of the holiday card series. Today I'm going to be using a stamp set from Lawn Fawn. It's this one right here. It's called And a Partridge. I think the illustration is so cute for a partridge in a pear tree. I'm going to keep today's card really, really simple. I'm planning to do a circle around the tree and do some ink blending into the circle. So I'm going to go ahead and start by picking out a circle die that fits just around the tree. All right, looks like this is the 3-inch. Yep, 3-inch circle. It's going to fit just around that tree. I'm going to take some Eclipse masking tape. I used this before in a card for the series, and I'm going to cut out a circle. This is cut to, let's see, it's basically a standard size card. It's just slightly smaller, actually, width-wise. But as long as I get it centered, it should be fine. I think I'm going to have it cut right there. Alright, so that circle is cut out super easily. Okay, so here's my card front. I'm using some Basil Marshmallow cardstock. And before I adhere this down, I'm going to go ahead and stamp the tree. And I'm going to be doing a little bit of embossing. So I wanted to stamp the tree first without having the mask adhered. It's just going to hold in place while I figure this out. I'm going to do my powder tool first, just over that surface. That's going to go over top. Then I have my VersaMark. Really pressing this down because I want to get a really good impression. I'm using Ranger Silver Embossing Powder. This is the Super Fine Detail embossing powder. And like I've shown you guys before, you can use a brush to clean up any embossing powder that's sticking around. Alright, so now I've got this mask, which I'm going to be super careful taking the backer off because I can reuse it on another card. Okay. Okay, I have Stampin' Up's Lucky Limeade, and I'm going to bring it in along the edges with this blending tool. And just because I'm worried about this edge right here, I'm going to take a post-it note, really large post-it note, and I'm just going to add that right there, just to save myself a little bit of grief later. So I'm really going to bring it in just from the edges. Really light touches. If you guys remember, that's what I learned. I'm almost using more post-its than the actual mask, but that's okay. So I'm gonna peel the mask up. Actually, before I do that, I'm just gonna just take a little cloth and clean off the embossing powder, the melted embossing powder. I just want to make sure that there wasn't any ink along the top of it. Then I can put this back on the backer sheet. It won't be perfect, but it'll be close enough that I can save it for use another time. All right, so now that I know where that circle is, I'm going to go ahead and stamp this greeting. Trying to not get any on the circle. And I'm going to round these corners with a 1/2-inch corner rounder. All right, I happen to have a Lucky Limeade marker. So I'm going to come in and color in the pears. Okay, I'm going to take these post-its and I'm going to just kind of place them around this bird's belly because I'm going to sponge on a little bit of color and I want to make sure that it doesn't get on the white areas. Just going to bring a little bit of soft pool in. I just looked it up online and partridges have sort of like a metallic blue brown color on their bellies. So I thought it'd be kind of fun to bring just a little bit of blue on his belly. Just for a little pop of color. Bring just a tinge of brown just to soften his belly color just a tiny bit. He's a little bright. I'm going to take these off. Actually, I sort of like the blue. I should have kept it. I have a pool party marker and I wonder if it would be too much blue. We'll go ahead and try it. Added some color to his belly. Now I wish I would have left it alone. Well, it's drawing back a little bit more of a tealish blue, so it's actually kind of pretty. Okay, and because I just can't leave things alone, I'm going to take a silver Uniball Signal pen and I'm going to go around the outer edge of the green. I'm just going to do a dashed line. It's going to give a little bit of silver. Alright, so there's the card for today. Super simple, really classy. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I will catch you guys next time. Thanks for watching.